Welcome to the Trading with a Bot channel. A week ago I had shared with you a 3 commas bot, which I called a tiny long doge. You'll find the links to the previous video and the bot in the description below. I will continue to run this bot for as long as possible, so that you can see the history of its profits. The price of Dogecoin had mainly decreased during the last week, and the main fluctuation had happened between June 7th and June 10th. There were two phases when the price was dropping rapidly, each about 8%, and the bot had handled them just fine. DCA bots make most of their profits when the prices move, and either direction, up or down, is acceptable. You are, however, constrained by the configuration of your bot and your budget. Today, I'd like to spend time on the topic of configuration, and another video in a week's time will cover the topic of budget and liquidation. Let us go back to the 3commas website and edit the bot that we've created last week. As I mentioned, the high fluctuation in prices we saw during June 7th, 8th and 9th had also resulted in a higher profit during these days. I used 50x, the highest possible leverage available for Dogecoin, and the minimum balance I recommend for this bot is 25 USDT. In a week of time this bot had made close to $5, which would imply that it is producing around 20% of profit per week. Can we extend this bot to give it more budget, or adopt it to another coin? Yes, but first let's review the details of the current configuration. I'll go now into an edit mode, to go over the settings of this DCA bot. This bot is running on Binance Futures Exchange, which I call my main account. This is a long-only strategy, and my base and safety order sizes are equal to 5 USDT. Next, my leverage is set to the highest value available to the Dogecoin on Binance Futures Exchange. Moving on, the deal start condition is set to open new trade ASAP, which means that as soon as the bot sells with a profit, it opens a new deal at a market price. You could also open a new deal with a limit order. I am comfortable to use the market price for a high volume coin such as Doge. Next, my target profit percent is set to 0.35, and I take profit percentage from the total volume. And finally, I am using 6 safety orders for this bot, and I open them when the price drops by 2.7% below my initial order. Each consecutive safety order is larger than the previous, because I use a scale of 1.9, but the distance between them decreases, because my safety order step scale is 0.7. Let me now show you why I had chosen this particular configuration. My sincere thanks goes to a TradingView user Ruam, who had created a backtesting strategy for some of the 3commas algorithms. If you go to thetradingview.com, and type in 3commas DCA in the search bar, and change the search category to scripts, you will find the strategy that I had used to discover these settings. Of course, I also left a direct link to this strategy below in the description of this video. The scripts are often updated, so as of this moment there is already a version 2, which I am now opening. Then, I add this script to my favorites by pressing the blue button below. Now I will open a price chart for Dogecoin. I will search for DogeUSDT, and from the many results that are shown, I will choose the price chart data from the Binance Exchange. The price of the Dogecoin is sufficiently volatile, as you can visually see from this graph. There are some other coins that are even less stable, such as Shiba Inu, 1000 SHIB, coin, and I do not recommend experimenting with the very volatile coins. My own experiments with such coins as Shibu usually ended up with a loss. The backtesting that we are about to do will give us an indication of the past performance. It does not guarantee the future performance. I had set my time interval to 15 minutes, and I click on Indicators and Strategies button on the top menu. With the favorites selected on the left, I'll see the strategies I had bookmarked. The backtesting 3commas DCA bot V2 is there too, so I will click on it to add this strategy to the price chart. Now, it is added, You see the name of the strategy shown in the top left corner, and also there appears to be an informational green box, that is a part of the strategy. I will pull up the bottom pane to see the tester interface. This bottom pane gives an overview of the strategy. Here we will see the net profit for a number of transactions within the defined time period. The Performance Summary tab provides a summary of key statistics, such as possible profit or losses associated with the strategy, average profit per trade, max drawdown, and several others. And finally, you can go to the List of Trades tab to see the individual buy and sell transactions that would have happened if the strategy was employed on this particular coin. I will now go back to the Overview tab and press the gear icon. This is where the strategy is taking its inputs and configuration. There are three tabs in this new pop-up window: inputs, properties, and style. Let's start with the properties tab and edit the initial capital amount. We'll start it with $25 US, and I am also updating the commission amount to 0.04%. Note how the net profit figure will change after I make my updates. Net profit is one of the main characteristics that I am observing for this particular backtester. On other strategies, I also look at the average trade percent, or the max drawdown percent, but here, for now, let's ignore the rest and focus only on the net profit. The style tab only influences the visual part of the strategy, so I will remove the information box, but leave the signal labels on. There's nothing else I want to update in Properties tab, so I'll move on to the Inputs. This is where we provide the main configuration of the DCA bot that we saw on 3 commas. Deal start condition should be start ASAP, since this is the algorithm for the Tiny Doge. There are other algorithms available, and if you're interested, please drop me a comment below and I will cover them as well. Next, I change take profit percent to 0.35, and it is from the total volume. If I scroll down here, I can also change the time frame for the back testing. I can put a start and an end date here, so let me choose a starting date in January or February, a reasonable period to test this strategy. Now you can see that this strategy is making a negative return, but we have not finished with all of the configuration. I put 0 on trailing take profit, because I do not use it for this bot. Let me go back to 3 commas, to show you where you could enable it, if you wanted to use the trailing take profit deviation. I am not using it, so I'll go back to the back test and put 0. Similarly, I am not using a stop loss here, so I keep 0. Next, the order size type is fixed, but I could also use a percent of my funds. And my base and safety orders are equal to $5. Stay mindful to how the net profit in the strategy overview pane is changing when I update these values. We're reaching the end of the configuration soon. Next, I change the max safety trades count to 6. Because that's the amount of safety orders I use on the Tiny Doge script. The price deviation to open safety order percent is 2.7. Let me go back to the 3 commas interface again, to remind you of these settings. Here's the max safety order count. My bot will open 6 grids lines, if the price will continue to drop. The price deviation to open the first grid is 2.7% below the base order. And the size of each position will be multiplied by 1.9, I am increasing my positions, as the price drops. And finally, as the price drops, my grids will be tighter. If I used a value above 1, they would be more and more spaced out. So now, I will just replicate the rest of the settings that I used on the Tiny Doge in 3 commas, to the back test strategy in TradingView. I will close the input window by pressing OK button. Now the strategy is also drawing the buy and sell signals. And the total net profit for the back test period from 1st of February is 2,276%. This backtesting script is a very good simulation of how the 3, DCA bot is working. Here, for example, you can see the individual trades that the bot would make, following this strategy. Here I need to set your expectations. Do not expect to make over 2000% in profit in half a year. It might be possible, but there are several other variables. Also remember that the past performance does not guarantee the future results. Anyway, the net profit figure that we saw a moment ago is important, because it shows how a particular configuration of the bot is going to perform. I will now go back and modify some of the inputs of the Tiny Doge bot's configuration. Keep an eye on the net profit figure, in the bottom left corner, while I modify the settings. I'll start by changing the take profit percent. I like to keep a relatively low target profit percent on my ASAP DCA bots. But look what would have happened if I increased it from 0.35%. The net profit would also increase. And this is the relevance of this figure. I use net profit figure as a benchmark of the settings. You can increase this percent on your bot, if you'd like. Modifying this setting, unlike some other settings, will not increase your risks, and may very well increase your profit. Let me know if you decide to make this experiment. As you can see, the number of total trades decreases, but your gains are certainly appearing to increase. And this is how I go about backtesting. I check different values for different fields, and see how they impact the net profit. Again, I need to repeat, if you were to use a different strategy, you would also need to check other parameters, such as maximum drawdown. Another input that increases your net profit is the size of your base order, but this one I do not recommend you to change until you understand the budget requirements for trading with leverage. This will be the topic of my next video, so please stay tuned for that. Same applies for the safety order size. I think that one of the most important settings is the price deviation to open safety order. This percentage value tells the bot when to open the first grid. In my case it is 2.7%, but watch what happens to the net profit when I change this figure. Increasing the space even by one decimal actually decreases my profit. And when I decrease it from 2.7, it appears the back test breaks. Do you see that the bottom panel became red now? I will not take the time to investigate it now, but we'll check this out later. Possibly there was a price movement that would break the flow of this bot, if the setting was set below 2.7%. If I change the backtesting period, I see that the backtest is working again. So let me leave this value at 2.7%, and move to the next input. Next is the scale for your safety order size. Increasing the scale increases the size of your safety orders. You are spending more money, increasing your position, and thus it is logical that your net profit will also increase. I give my Tiny Doge bot the safety order scale of 1.9, because I saw a large jump in the net profit comparing to 1.8 or 1.7. In this way I tried to balance the investment needed for this bot and the return from this investment. And finally, after the size scale, we will finish with the step scale. I will do another video to demonstrate this visually, but this value is, basically, dictates the density of the grid. If you reduce the step scale, your grid will be narrower. This backtests to more profit, but I was concerned that the bot may be less effective if the price drops by a lot. As of this configuration, I am using 6 safety orders, first one being positioned 2.7% below the base order, and the subsequent orders spaced at a value of 2.7 multiplied by 0.7. In total, the bot covers a straight fall of 7.9%, and in my experience, so far, this had been sufficient. This is the reason I do not want to decrease the step scale even more. And also increasing it seems to significantly impact the net profit. The only improvement here would be an increase of the safety order numbers, but this would require a larger balance, and as I mentioned, this is going to be the topic for the next video. When we understand the budget requirements, and the risks associated with such a bot, we can backtest more coins and consider opening more bots to run in parallel. Alternatively, we can give the tiny Doge more funding. And, what we also should aim for the next time, is to try to make our bot less risky.